Hello everyone, in last session we learned the topic the sky. In that we learned about solar system. In solar system there are 9 planets till 2005. After 2005 Pluto was considered as a dwarf planet. Now we says that in solar system there are 8 planets according to their distance from the sun. So in solar system how many planets are there? In solar system there are 8 planets. Pluto was considered as dwarf planet. See students, one by one, the name of first planet is Mercury, second Venus, next Earth. Guess the next one. Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and last one Neptune. And Pluto was considered as dwarf planet. Okay dear students, now I am going to show you a list of period of rotation and revolution of the planet is given on the basis of Earth timing. We know that every planets have character of rotation and revolution. Now I am going to show you a list of planets period of rotation and revolution. Let's see one by one. See students, a list of period of rotation and revolution of the planets is given on the basis of Earth's timing. There are 3 columns. One is planets, second one is duration of Earth rotation, next one is duration of Earth's revolution. From these we can easily identify the rotation and revolution takes place in a particular planet. See, first one is Mercury. In Mercury we saw there are 2 types of movement. One is rotation and another one is revolution. Mercury takes 59 days. How many days? 59 days for rotation. As well as Mercury takes the time of 88 days for revolution. This is the time period for planet Mercury rotation and revolution. Mercury takes 59 days for rotation and 88 days for revolution. Next, second one planet is Venus. What is the planet name? Second planet. Second planet is Venus. Venus takes 243 days for rotation. As well as Venus takes 225 days for revolution. Observe carefully students, here rotation is 243 days and revolution is 225 days. Venus revolution is more compared to the rotation. Okay, next third one planet is, what is the name of third planet? Third planet is Earth. See the rotation and revolution of Earth. Earth rotation takes 24 hours and revolution takes 365 × 1/4 days, or we also says that 365.25 days. Here Earth rotation means 24 hours. 24 hours is nothing but 1 day. We says one rotation of Earth is called as 1 day. Okay, for revolution, Earth revolution, Earth takes 365.25 days, or 365 × 1/4 days. We commonly consider the round number, that is 365. 365 Earth revolution means we also says that 1 year. 1 year is nothing but 365 days, but particularly Earth takes 365 into 1 by 4 days for revolution. Next, fourth one planet is, what is the name of fourth planet after Earth? Next one is planet Mars. See the rotation and revolution time, students. Here Mars takes 24 hours 37 minutes for rotation. For rotation, Mars takes how much time? 24 hours 37 minutes. For revolution, Mars takes 686 days. How much revolution time? Time period? Mars takes 686 days for revolution. Okay, after that, next one planet is Jupiter. Planet Jupiter. Jupiter takes 10 hours for rotation and 12 years for revolution. Okay, see carefully, student. Here, days, years are changed. So, concentrate. Jupiter takes 10 hours for rotation and 12 years for revolution. Next, after Jupiter, the planet name is Saturn. Saturn takes, how much time Saturn takes for rotation? Saturn takes 10 hours 39 minutes for rotation and 29 and half years for its revolution. This is the duration of rotation and revolution of Saturn. Next one is the planet Uranus. Uranus takes 17 hours 13 minutes for rotation and 84 years for revolution. Okay, next last one planet is, what is the last planet? Last planet is Neptune. Neptune takes 16 hours 23 minutes for rotation and 165 years for revolution. Okay, carefully observe, students. Observe this column. See the duration of Earth's revolution. Here now I am going to choose yellow color to show different units. First 88 days to 25 days. 365 into 1 by 4 days, 686 days. Okay, the four planets' revolution is measured in days. Then the remaining planet, like Jupiter, takes 12 years, 29 and half years, 84 years, and 165 years. The duration of revolution of Jupiter to Neptune consider in year. So, must and should remember. The rotation and revolution is mentioned in hours, minutes, or days, years. It helps to identify the rotation and revolution of different planets easily. Next, see students. First one question. Which planet takes the least time to complete one revolution around the sun and why? Observe. See the question. Which planet takes the least time to complete one revolution around the sun? In question ask revolution. So, we need to saw in the column of revolution. See students, here first starting four planets are given in days, takes the time of revolution in days. Next four planets is in years. Now, we are going to search which planet takes least time. Least time is nothing but minimum time. We know that year is greater than day. So, we need to search in a day. See 686, 365, 225, 88. Which one is least? Yes, which one is minimum? Here, 88 days is minimum. So, we can easily say the answer. Can you guess what is the answer? See students, Mercury has the shortest orbit period of any planet in the solar system, completing a trip around the sun every 88 days. It is the smallest of the 8 planets as well as the closest to the sun. Next, see the second one question. Which planet takes the most time to complete one revolution around the sun? See, which planet takes the most time to complete revolution? Means we need to saw in the column of revolution which planet takes most time. Yes, tell me students. Here first 4 planets are given in days and next 4 in years. Which one is greatest? Yes, 165 years greatest, because Neptune takes 165 years for revolution. Then tell me students, what is the answer? Yes, tell me what is the answer for second one question. Is Neptune is the answer, because Neptune takes 165 years for revolution. So correct answer is Neptune. Next, see third question. Which planet takes more time to complete one rotation than its revolution? Yes, observe the column students. Observe carefully. Which takes, the planet takes more time to complete one rotation than its revolution? Yes, what is the answer? See students, here Venus. Venus takes 243 days for rotation and 225 days for revolution. When compared to rotation and revolution, rotation time is more. So we say that Venus planet takes more time to complete one rotation than its revolution. Okay, see students, next one is, next one activity, which is given in your textbook, EBS textbook, page number 189. See the question. Features of some planets are given below. Mention the name of the planets against each of them. Okay, we already learned detail about planets. Then can you easily guess the which planet belongs to. Okay, first one is red planet. Which planet we called as red planet? Yes, tell me students, which planet we called as red planet? Mars planet we called as red planet. First one answer is Mars. Which planet we called as red planet? Mars planet we called as red planet. Next, see the second question. Brightest planet. Which is the brightest planet? Yes, guess. Brightest planet is Venus. Venus is the brightest planet. Which planet is the brightest planet? Venus is the brightest planet. Next, see the third question. Biggest planet. Which is the biggest planet in solar system? Yes, Jupiter is the biggest planet in solar system. Okay, name the planet again. Jupiter is the biggest planet in solar system. Next, see fourth one question. Blue green color planet. Which one is blue green color planet? Neptune is the blue green planet. Which planet? Neptune is the blue green planet. See the next question. Only planet that has life. That planet we also called as living planet, unique planet. Can you guess which one? Only planet that has life is the planet Earth. What is the answer? Earth is the answer. See the next question. Its day is longer than its year. Yes, we already saw in today's class only. Yes, tell me. Its day is longer than its year. That is Venus. The planet name is Venus. Okay, now I am going to ask one by one. Let's correct it once. See, the red planet. Which is the red planet? Mars is the red planet, brightest planet. Venus is the brightest planet, biggest planet in solar system. Jupiter is the biggest planet in the solar system. Blue-green color planet, Neptune. Fifth one question. Only planet that has life. Only planet that has life is Earth. Sixth one is, its day is longer than the year. Which one? Venus is the correct answer. Now, let's identify the name of planets in the letter grid given here. Now, I am going to show you a grid. Let's see, students, here is a grid. Identify the name of the planet in the letter grid given below. First one is example Jupiter. Here they already give Jupiter. Next, can you guess or identify the other planets' names? Yes, try once again. Yes, guess students, we know that there are 8 planets in solar system. Try how many planets you can identify. See students, here M-A-R-S, Mars. Mars is a planet. Planet of solar system. Next, yes, find quickly. Yes. Yes, you get the answer. Try it. Next one is, see, here Saturn. Saturn is also one planet of solar system. Next, yes, search it. See, students, here V-E-N-U-S. Venus is a planet of solar system. Then next, yes, try it. You are doing well. Where? See, here U-R-A-N-U-S. Uranus is also planet. Planet of solar system. Then next remaining planet. Yes. See here E-A-R-T-H. Earth. Earth is planet. Then the next planet is? Yes. M-E-R-C-U-R-Y. Mercury is also planet of solar system. Then last remaining planet is, can you identify the name of planet? That is Neptune. Neptune is a planet of solar system. Okay. Complete these activities in your EVS textbook. Next, see students. Now I'm going to ask a question. Can you answer? It's a very simple question. What is solar system? What is the answer? Recall and tell. What is solar system? You already learned from first class. Yes, the correct answer is, the sun and its family is known as the solar system. It comprises of 8 planets, 173 satellites, thousands of asteroids, meteorites and comets. In this, we already learnt about the 8 planets of solar system in detail, but the remaining satellites, asteroids, meteorites and comets. Now, we are going to learn about the next meteoroids. Now we are going to learn about meteoroids. Let's see students. Meteoroids. Small fragments of rocks and debris in space are called meteoroids. When they enter the Earth's atmosphere, they burn up. When they enter the Earth's atmosphere, they burn up in the atmosphere. Due to friction and a streak of light is produced. They are known as shooting stars. Next one is asteroids. Small rocky celestial bodies revolving around the sun are called asteroids. Most of them are located between the orbit of Mars and Jupiter. This is about asteroids. The elliptical path followed by a celestial body around the sun is called orbit, that is the orbit. Small rocky celestial bodies revolving around the sun are called asteroids. Next one is comets. A comet is an icy body that gives out gas. or dust. They revolve around the sun. They can be seen in the night when they come close to the earth. When they come close to the sun, they produce a long tail which is made up of gas and dust. Some comets appear at regular intervals. Halley comet appears once in 76 years. The last time it appeared was in 1986. Okay students, now we learnt about asteroids, meteoroids and comets. What about satellites? You know the planet Earth. Earth satellite is? Yes, tell me. Satellite of Earth is? The moon is the satellite of Earth. A celestial body revolving around the planet is called a satellite. Here, celestial body is moon, which is revolving around the planet Earth. So we called as moon is the satellite of Earth. The moon is the only natural satellite of the Earth. It revolves around the Earth. It does not have light of its own. Okay, moon does not have its light, but it reflects the light from the sun during the night. See the picture? Reflection of light. The Earth satellite is the moon. The moon is the only natural satellite of the Earth. It revolves around the Earth. It does not have light of its own. It reflects the light of the sun during the night. Movement of the moon. The moon has two movements. One is rotation on its axis and other is revolution around the Earth. See the movement of Earth and the moon. All the planets are orbiting around the sun. Every planet have two types of changes are two types of movements. One is rotation and another one is revolution. The moon has two movements. One is rotation on its axis and other is revolution around the earth. As the moon revolves around the earth, its position in the relation to the sun changes from night to night. As a result, we can see that the phases of the moon. The changes in the moon's visible phase is as a phase of the moon. You will learn more about this in the higher classes also. The moon revolves around the earth in a fixed orbit. The moon does not have its own light. When the moon is between the earth and the sun, we cannot see the moon at all. This is because the side of the moon facing the earth does not get sunlight. This is called new moon. When the moon is completely dark, we call it new moon. After 2 to 3 days, we can see some part of the moon. This phase is called waxing crescent. As the moon is gaining light, that is expanding in illumination, we use the term waxing. About a week after the new moon, we can see half of the moon. This phase is called first quarter. 2 or 3 days after the first quarter, more than half of the moon is visible. This phase is called the waxing gibbous. About 2 weeks after the new moon, we can see the full moon. This is because the full side of the moon facing the earth. Full moon, when we see its bright side totally, we call it full moon. Now the moon begins its return journey from the full moon to the new moon. This is called the phases of moon. As the moon is now losing light, that is decreasing in illumination, we use the term waning. The next phase is the last quarter, followed by the waning crescent. When the moon comes back between the earth and the sun, it enters the new moon. Number of days between two new moons is 29, as the moon takes approximately 29 days to revolve one around. These changing shapes of the moon are called phases of the moon. One day. What do you mean by one day? One day means the duration taken by the earth to complete one rotation on its axis is called as a day or one day. Then tell me, students, what you mean by 1 year? 1 year. 1 year means as the earth rotates on its axis, the duration taken by it to complete one revolution around the sun is called a year or 1 year. Earth completes its one revolution, we called as 1 year. In 1 year, 365 into 1/4 days. 1 month means the duration taken by the moon to complete one revolution around the earth is called 1 month. Okay, dear students, today in this class we learnt about solar system. We know that the sun and its family is known as solar system. We already learnt about 8 planets. Now in this class we learnt about asteroids, meteoroids, comets, and there are 173 satellites, but we are learnt only about the satellite moon. Moon we called as Earth satellites. Okay, I hope you understood the class and enjoyed the class about the topic the sky. Thank you.